very small bald spot. I'm 22 years old. About how many grafts and how much money would it cost to repair these two bald spots that were caused by cuts during my childhood?
Thank you for your question. At the age of 22, you've submitted a question about two bald spots, the result of childhood trauma that resulted in areas of patches that don't grow hair. And you're asking about how much it would cost and how many grafts you would need. Well, it's first important to define by physical examination the type of scarring that is present. And that's something I can't do from this, just looking at your photos. But there are a couple of concepts that I want you to learn about and I think will be helpful in you making a decision. First of all, assuming by the photos that you are of African descent or that you have the tight, very curly hair, hair quality, then we have a couple of things that you need to be aware of when it comes to making decisions about doing transplants. First of all, when you wear your hair very short, you have to understand that any type of donor, which means taking hair from the permanent zone in the back and moving it to the front, whether you do an FUT or follicular unit transplant or a FUE, follicular unit extraction, where one is the traditional donor strip, where a strip of hair is removed versus the newer, more recently very popular concept of removing hair from little punches. When you wear your hair short, some kind of scarring will be present. So you have to be mindful of that. And in my practice, I generally recommend a strip, and I'll explain why I do. But before going on to that, let's now go on to another concept. Numbers of grafts. For most people of African origin, the hair can look, have a lot of volume, but the space between the hair follicles is actually greater than it is for Caucasians or Asians. And essentially the hair grows in a circular or curly pattern. And so you can understand that if they're too close together, there could be problems with ingrown hairs. So when we evaluate someone for a hair transplant, we look at the area that needs to be transplanted and we estimate how many hairs can be placed in a way that would respect the blood supply to the hair as well as are likely to survive and make it. One of the things that even in an area when you do transplanted, when you transplant hair that is not a scar, like in a case like yourself, you still don't get 100% growth of all the grafts that are placed with traditional hair transplant. So that brings me to the next concept. In my practice, we have been fortunate to be in a leadership position in this concept I refer to as hair regeneration. Now, although this doesn't apply to you at this point, but understanding that hair loss or hair thinning has to do with stem cell-based activity of hair follicles such that when hair is thinning, those stem cells become inactive and the hair disappears. Well, we've been using a material called extracellular matrix to assist with hair loss from male pattern or female pattern hair loss, but we've also used it, and this is actually the origin of the basis of our use for non-surgical treatment, we have also used it for hair transplant. You see, the idea is if with advanced cell regenerative healing, the yield of the transplant becomes considerably greater. So we would actually use this extracellular matrix that we're using that's manufactured by a company called Acell, and we would apply it to a transplant. so that when we place the hair follicles are more likely to make it, as well as the donor area where we harvest would also heal better. There is no technology that eliminates scars altogether, but I have found that a lot of people who are of African descent who wear their hair very short, even with a good scar, an incisional scar or FUE scars, you could still see it. So you have to be very, very careful about the choice. A lot of times I suggest to our patients that they actually allow their hair to grow a little bit so that it would cover part of the scar the way it would with just a little bit of length. Nonetheless, in terms of your treatment plan, we would have a discussion about the number of hairs you would need. I would evaluate the scar tissue. Now, in my practice, I have transplanted hair in a lot of areas, including scar tissue. People who have had burns from the caustic materials where there's virtually a round circle in a patch, I've placed hair grafts and I've successfully been able to grow hair. So it's remarkable how resilient a hair follicle can be with a minimum amount of support, even in a thin scar. Now, with this new technology of hair regeneration or stem cell based, and when I say stem cells, I mean adult stem cells, not fetal stem cells, that can even further enhance the healing ability of the hair follicle. There's an opportunity to get you the best result possible. You see, a lot of times when people have hair transplant, if they have straight hair, even if they have not such great scars, if you grow your hair long, it can fall down and it can cover. But someone like yourself really requires optimal treatment at every level, because in so many ways, there's very little forgiveness for something where you would be able to see the results of having had a procedure, and that's the kind of attention you don't want. So in summary, I think you would be a good candidate for a hair transplant. I can't, you know, costs of these procedures vary from region to region, and it would require really a physical exam. So it would be unfair to quote you how much it would cost. But understanding the number of hairs that need to be delivered, how the hairs will be harvested, and what are the and using advanced technology, to me, should be a standard of care. Now that we have been able to succeed with this material and have been demonstrating it over the past 2.5 years in my practice. So I think that you have an opportunity to learn more and make a decision and a choice when you are ready. And so I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.